In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today, let us reflect over the theme called The Hope of Resurrection Brings New Life. The Hope of Resurrection Brings New Life. First and foremost, I would like to pose a question to each and everyone. What is the resurrection? Do I really believe in the hope of resurrection, or do I ignore the hope of resurrection? Do I really believe in the hope of resurrection, or do I ignore the hope of resurrection? Let us now understand it in a deeper way. We see in Catechism of the Catholic Church, article number 998 says, who will rise? All the dead people will rise. Those who do good deeds, they get the resurrection of life, and those who do evil deeds, they get the condemnation. That's why we also see in, as St. Paul writes, letter to 1 Corinthians, how can some of you say that there is no resurrection of the dead? If there is no resurrection of the dead, Christ has not been raised. If Christ has not been raised, our preaching is in vain and your faith is in vain. We see this aspect in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 14. And we need to understand, as St. Paul explicitly tells in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 14, if there is no resurrection of the dead, if Christ has not been raised, our preaching is in vain and your faith is in vain. My dear faithful in Jesus Christ, we need to always believe in the hope of resurrection. And we are leading and living our lives on the basis of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And we need to hope for the resurrection of Christ in our lives. And we also see the hope of resurrection brings new life. We observe death is a mystery. We understand death is a mystery. When one person is born in this world, only that person cries, and all the people who are surrounding him, they are very joyful. In a similar way, the same person, when he dies, he only rejoices, and all the people who are surrounded him, they are very sad and unhappy. That's why, my dear faithful in Jesus Christ, death is a mystery. It is clear, it is true, when the person is born in this world, he alone cries, and all the people who are surrounded him, they are very joyful. And the same person dies, he only rejoices, he is only joyful, and all the people who are surrounding him, they are very sad. That's why death is a mystery, and it is not, death is painful, but it is also joyful. It is joyful because Jesus Christ gives consolation, Jesus Christ gives confidence, Jesus Christ gives a ray of hope to all the people, that one day we too may be raised by Jesus Christ. And we need to believe this aspect of resurrection in our lives. Death is not opposite to life, but it is part of life. Death is not opposite to life, but it is part of life. The person who is born in this world one day has to die, whether he or she likes or not. But it is an inevitable reality which everyone passes in his or in her life. That's why death, it always remains as a mystery, and it is not always, it is not opposite to life, but it is part and parcel of life. That's why we see in St. John's Gospel, chapter 11, verse 25, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even though they die, they will live forever. That's why, for a believer, one who believes in Christ, death is a passage from the earthly pilgrimage to the heavenly homeland where the Almighty Father establishes the interconnectedness with all His children. For this, as we live in this world, we need to prepare ourselves for one thing. We do PhD by our profession, and we need to do a PhD in our life. You might be surprised, what is that PhD? PhD. P means preparation for, H means happy, D means death. Preparation for happy death. You and I are called to do preparation for a happy death. When we prepare ourselves for a happy death, surely we are going to see that eternal beatitude. We are going to see that eternal happiness, that we are going to get the resurrection of life which Jesus Christ wants to give to each and every one of us here. That's why, as St. Paul writes to Philippians chapter 1 verse 21, "For to me to live is Christ and to die is gain. For to me to live is Christ and to die is gain." My dear faithful in Jesus Christ, as we hope for the resurrection, we need to be with Jesus Christ, and we need to always hope for resurrection in our daily lives, and we need to consider ourselves. We need to consider death. It is a passage from the earthly pilgrimage to the heavenly homeland. There we meet the Almighty Father. So, my dear faithful in Jesus Christ, let us be hopeful and let us always pray for our God. Let the fragrance of the resurrection of Jesus Christ may reach to the people who are at the fringes of the church and the people who are last and the least. Let the fragrance of resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ may reach to the people who are at the fringes of the church and the people who are the least and the lost. May God bless all of you. Amen.